Layers are a way to organize your content in Articulate Storyline. If you have a lot of information that you need to deliver to the user, sometimes it's really easy to put it all on one slide, but it's only possible if you use layers. Layers are pretty easy, especially if you already know a little bit about triggers and states. So go ahead and stay tuned and I'll show you how to do it in just 5 minutes. I'm Lindsay and I cover instructional design, e-learning development, and all things online teaching and learning. Okay, so I've already got a slide set up here. I'm going to show you how to build a really simple tab interaction, these being the tabs on the left here. I've already pulled some clip art for a dog, cat, and rabbit here. Sometimes I like to have a slide where I put all of my media so I can just copy and paste it when I'm ready. And each of these is just a simple shape. I did already set up the states down below here to make it a little bit fancier. And over here on the right is just an empty box. Okay, so let's go ahead down here on the right to the layers pane. Go ahead and create a new layer. I like to be very tidy when I create new content so that when I create my triggers, it's very straightforward. So this one is going to be the dog layer. I'm also going to create a cat layer and a rabbit layer. Right, so the base layer stays the same. Let me just call it the animals layer. And then each of these right now is empty. But you can see when you select the layers, the base layer grays out to make it easier to edit the content on your layer. So layers are just like a window. It's like a window that's clear until you put stuff on it. Like you draw some pictures, you put some stickers up there. It's very straightforward. So for my animal slide, what I want to happen is when someone clicks the dog button to have the dog layer up here. So let's go ahead and build out our layers and then we will set up the triggers. So I will copy the dog picture, make sure I'm the dog layer, go ahead and paste it here. I want to give the illusion that the dog is showing up in the box here on the right. So I'll put it there kind of towards the top of the box. Let's grab that cat picture, go to the cat layer, paste that in. Put it kind of towards the top there. And last but not least, grab that little bunny, pop over here, make sure I'm on the rabbit layer, and paste in the rabbit. Okay. You can also add in text as well. Again, layers are a way to organize content. You can put all sorts of things in layers. You can do audio, you can do video, you could do iframes or embedded web pages. The sky is really the limit, but you might experience some lag if you have too much media on one slide. So just keep that in mind. If you have any issues, maybe spread it out to multiple layers. And you can add in several things all at once. You can add in text to go with your image. You can add in several things here. Okay, so that's fine. I'll just go ahead and leave that there for illustration purposes. And next we need to set up our triggers. So I'll set up one for dog. Again, I've done a pretty good job of naming things. I haven't named these buttons though, but what we're gonna do is change this to show layer dog. When the user clicks, user clicks rectangle one, and I didn't do my job of making sure I named these, but that can be really helpful when you are setting up your triggers. So let's go ahead and do that really fast. Don't want to select the wrong rectangle and get really confused. Okay, so I already set up that trigger for this one. I'm going to copy that, select the cat button, paste that onto the cat button, and we're going to make sure that's set up correctly for the cat button, and I'm going to paste that onto the rabbit button as well. So again, I'm just selecting the button here and then hitting that paste since I already copied it. Rabbit, when they click rabbit button. All right, that should be it. Let's go ahead and preview this slide. The initial view, it is blank. You can see my states are working quickly on my buttons. But as you click each of these, it'll show dog, it'll show cat, it will show rabbit. And more significantly, you can see that as you select each one, the other layer is hidden. So when you have the dog layer up and you click cat, the dog layer becomes hidden. Now, how these layers behave can be customized down here. You can go down here to the bottom right, right click on one of the layers and choose properties. And for each of these layers, you can choose what happens. It defaults to hiding the other layers, But you can also choose to hide objects on the base layer. You can choose to automatically hide the layer when the timeline finishes. For example, if you had an animation or a video and that comes to an end, the layer can automatically hide itself. You can also choose what happens when users come back to the slide. So if they leave the slide and come back, the default is automatically decide, but you can also have these definitely reset to the initial state or resume a save state when the user comes back and visits. So there's all sorts of things you can do with layers. Sometimes it is really fun to have all the layers visible at once if you have a lot of content that you want to show on screen. But really, it's completely up to you and what you want to accomplish. I just recommend really thinking out what you want to happen before you dive in and start building out your layers. And as always, be sure to name all of your objects because your life will be much easier when you are setting up those triggers. What do you think? Any other videos you want to see? Go ahead and leave me a comment down below.